If your pet starts behaving in this bizarre way, you should take it to the vet immediately. It's a normal day at home and you're sitting in the living room with your beloved pet. But as you continue to relax, you notice that the animal is pressing its head against the wall. Then it does the same against a door. While it appears innocuous, alarm bells should be ringing because it's not as harmless as it seems. As a pet owner, you must keep a watchful eye over your animal throughout the day. After all, that's the best way to spot troubling issues such as head pressing at an early stage. However, that might be easier said than done if you don't know what to look for. Indeed, it can be difficult to gauge the behavior of certain animals at times, but regardless of your ability to read some of the more subtle aspects of a pet's body language, head pressing can be quite obvious, and it's something that you have to be aware of going forward. As we mentioned earlier, head pressing shouldn't be brushed off as something normal by animals such as cats and dogs. In addition to them, this behavioral pattern is also displayed by goats, cows, and horses too. So if you happen to see your pet pushing their cranium against a flat surface, they require urgent help. In recent times, the United States has boasted some incredible figures when it comes to pet ownership. To give you an idea of the steady growth, the American Pet Products Association, APPA, ran a study back in 1998. After going over the results, it revealed that 56% of homeowners had an animal under their roof. Some three decades on, the organization supervised another study in 2019, which showed that 67% of American homes own a pet. Now, dogs and cats were at the top of that particular list, proving how popular they still are. So with that in mind, it's obvious that those who look after them have to know about head pressing. First of all, though, let's make sure you don't mistake it for something else. See, if you own a pet cat, you'll notice that they often bump their cranium against parts of your anatomy, sometimes with force. Although it might look familiar, these actions shouldn't be confused with head pressing. In fact, it's a very common behavior amongst felines that's referred to as head bunting. To explain more, feline aficionado Pam Johnson Bennett shared some interesting insights with the PetMD website. She said, "When cats head bunt, they're creating a communal scent in a free-roaming universe. Cats recognize each other by scent first and foremost. Their whiskers and pupils are relaxed, their ears are also relaxed." On Johnson Bennett's point about scents, head bunting allows cats to spread their fragrance throughout the house, and it could be interpreted as a way of marking territory, yet PetMD suggested a much deeper meaning. According to the website, if you're on the receiving end of a head bump, you're seen as part of the feline's colony. Furthermore, another expert in feline behavior claimed that head bunts are a sign of affection to their owners as well. Speaking to PetMD, Ingrid Johnson explained, "The cats are saying, 'I love you. You're so wonderful, but you're also a little stinky. Let's get you smelling like us.'" Expanding on that, Johnson shared some fascinating information about the way that cats navigate the world. Indeed, she drew a comparison between them and their respective guardians, highlighting how we're often oblivious to their focus on scents. You see, cats can activate their own scent glands on their head above their eye by head bunting. So what they're actually doing is putting their own scent on you. Head bunting is like a mutual love session between a person and furniture, Johnson continued. We don't always realize that cats live in a very scent-laden world. Humans are visual. We forget that there are so many scent glands on them. It's like they're leaving little kitty text messages. As for how you should reply to a cat's head bunt, PetMD suggests that you could reciprocate their gesture. From offering a cranial bump of your own to tenderly rubbing their chin, these actions can further establish your bond together. However, Johnson Bennett provided an important counterpoint for those who are still building a relationship with their pet. Yes, Johnson Bennett told the website, some cats may not be comfortable with a response, so wait until it head bunts you the next time. Then maybe you can reach out your hand to build trust. Once that trust is in place, the experts believe that owners are in a very privileged position with their animal. You should be thrilled that the cat has chosen you, Johnson Bennett claimed. Enjoy it and take it as a compliment that you're worthy of their affection, that they've deemed you good enough. The more you foster a relationship with your cat, the more she'll want to headbutt you. Meanwhile, Johnson Bennett was keen to share another point during her conversation with PetMD. As we mentioned earlier, head bunting could be seen as a cat's way of marking their domain in their house. But according to the feline expert, that's a misinterpretation of a genuinely heartfelt gesture from the animal. "That sounds so cold," Johnson Bennett claimed. "Headbunting is typically an affectionate behavior. People think in black and white terms of cats' behavior. We show affection with a hug, a kiss, or by holding hands. Cats have so many ways of being physically close. They touch noses, which is like a handshake. Headbunting is the next step. It's like a hug." So, given what we now know about headbunting, it'll be a lot easier to recognize when we're at home. To add to that, the differences between this behavior and head pressing also become clearer. If you're still unsure on the latter, though, here are the signs that you should be looking out for. As suggested before, there could be a problem with your pet if it continues to push its head against a flat surface. Whether it's a wall, door, or the floor, cats and dogs are known to stick to these areas when there's an issue. Regarding felines, Johnson gave an example of the startling sight. Indeed, Johnson told PetMD, "They may walk up to a corner and push on both sides of the wall. Their face is wincing. Their head is throbbing. It's like us pushing into our temples when we have a headache. They may express excessive vocal irritability. They may howl like they're disoriented." What's more, the behavior of an affected dog is quite similar to that, as they'll often dig their forehead into the surface. Unsurprisingly, these actions can leave pet owners concerned, especially if the animal in question continues to do it. Should you find yourself in that situation, you must act as quickly as possible. For you see, head pressing is usually a sign of a serious illness in animals, and it might indicate that the cat or dog is suffering with a neurological ailment, in which case more problems can arise. With that in mind, canines are known to display the following symptoms alongside cranial pushing. One of the easiest symptoms to spot is an increase in the dog's pacing. It turns out that can cause issues with their feet, too, due to the constant walking. Furthermore, the sick pooch could exhibit some extreme signs such as seizure, a decrease in vision, and big alterations in their behavior. Concerning the underlying cause, the affected dog could be dealing with a condition like encephalitis or rabies. On the other hand, brain tumors can trigger similar symptoms in canines as well. But away from those ailments, there's an additional medical issue that might explain the constant head pressing. As you may already know, the liver is an incredibly important organ as it filters the blood from the digestive system. Unfortunately, though, some dogs carry an internal abnormality that alters that process in a major way. Known as a liver shunt, this causes unfiltered plasma to go past the organ. To explain more, a veterinarian named Jennifer Coates delved into the topic while writing for PetMD. According to her, there are two types of liver shunt that you find in different dogs. Dr. Coates wrote, "Liver shunts can be divided into two categories, those that are present at birth, congenital shunts, and those that develop later in life, acquired shunts." And Coates continued, "Congenital shunts are most common, being responsible for approximately 80% of cases. Dogs are usually quite young, less than 3 years old, when they start experiencing symptoms. Meanwhile, acquired shunts typically develop when blood pressure within the veins connecting the digestive tract to the liver become elevated. If a dog does have a liver shunt, head pressing is one of several symptoms they'll display. Keeping that in mind, you must take your animal to the vet when it starts doing this, as they should be able to help. In fact, Coates explained to PetMD how specialists would go about treating the previously mentioned ailment. Most small breed dogs who have congenital shunts have just one abnormal blood vessel that's located outside the liver," Coates wrote. "These are the most amenable to surgical correction. A single shunt that's located within the liver itself is more common in large breed dogs. These are still usually best treated with surgery." As for the head pressing in cats, there are some other potential causes for it. Much like their canine counterparts, brain tumors and rabies can trigger the problem in felines. But that's not all. Indeed, glandular issues and metabolic abnormalities are also conditions that could lead to it as well. Yet, whatever the cause may be, your cat will need to be assessed by a vet to ascertain the problem. Understandably, you might be a little worried about the test that your pet will undergo, so in an attempt to clear things up, an expert shed some light on the process. Yes, Dr. Katie Nelson, who plies her trade as a vet, provided an in-depth breakdown while writing for the PetMD website. She revealed, "In order to determine the underlying cause of the head pressing behavior, your veterinarian will likely perform a fundic examination of the retina. They'll also look at other structures in the back of the eye." And Dr. Nelson continued, These examinations may reveal irregularities in the brain or infectious or inflammatory diseases. Other helpful tests include blood pressure measurements to determine if your cat has high blood pressure, and computed tomography, CT, or magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, scans of the brain. Your veterinarian will also perform blood work and a urinalysis. From there, Nelson made it clear that you'd need to take note of your cat's behavior prior to seeing the vet. By mentioning any other strange signs you might have noticed, that gives them a better chance of reaching a solution. And while the process may be worrying, the results could save your pet's life. Regarding that point, Johnson Bennett reiterated the importance of watching over your cat at home. That allows you to get a better sense of how they're carrying themselves each day. Then, if they do begin to showcase a few unusual ticks, you'll be able to tell that something might be wrong. Johnson Bennett told PetMD, "It's those little things that pet owners discover about their cat's behavior that can make a real difference in the relationship. If you misunderstand subtle signs, it can have a huge impact on whether you have a close bond or not. We misinterpret cat communication all the time." Meanwhile, as we briefly alluded to, cats and dogs aren't the only animals out there that are prone to head pressing. When it comes to goats, they showcase that particular symptom after contracting a disease called caprine arthritis encephalitis, otherwise referred to as CAE. This medical ailment doesn't have a cure at present. Furthermore, the disease itself takes on two different forms, with the arthritis affecting goats between the ages of 1 and 2. As for the encephalitis strain, that's the one that causes the animal to press its cranium against the walls. Sadly, that form of CAE hits goats that are only a few months old. Alongside goats, horses will engage in head pressing when something isn't right too. To explain more, vet Doug Thal shared some interesting information about affected equines. Writing for the Horse Side Vet Guide website, he said, "Horses that are depressed or experiencing abdominal pain will often stand with their head in the corner of the stall." And Dr. Thal added, "Head pressing is a rare behavior and is usually associated with severe neurological disease. Horses showing true head pressing will usually show other signs of brain disease such as depression, loss of appetite, wobbliness, and apparent blindness. Horses that are dying of other causes such as intestinal rupture may also engage in this behavior."